Hi again, it's Chris with the Spirit Emporium. Thanks so much for coming back for another video from us. Today I'm going to be sharing with you using your pendulum. Now, we are, as I've said before, we are ghost hunters. We love to explore the paranormal, and one of the things that we like to use are our pendulums. Wendy and I both have our own sets of pendulums, and I have a couple that I use in different areas. I have one that I use on my paranormal investigations and one that I use strictly for my house. So there are a couple other things that you can use your pendulum for. You don't have to use it just for the purpose of communicating with spirits. You can also use your pendulum for locating lost items in your room. They also can bring about an ambient positive energy into your workspace. So, you know, using your pendulum in your workspace would be good for bringing about that kind of a positive vibe. If you've got a pendulum, great, get started right away and go use it. If not, go get you one. Because like I said, they're for us, they're great tools for paranormal investigations. We like to use them for communication. It's easy to use, it's easy to program, and I'll also show you one more thing that we use along with our pendulum. It's called a spirit board. Now, you might have seen these before. If you haven't, we do have them on our site, and it's just a simple board. It's got the yes, yes, and the no, no clearly marked for everyone to see. So if you are in the middle of an investigation, you want to bring out your pendulum, and you want to get those yes, no, maybe questions going, this way everyone is on the same page, because you've got it right there on the floor. You've got your pendulum right above it, and it's going to give you a clear answer. You have to program it still to, you know, so that you understand your pendulum. Your pendulum understands what it wants from you. Yes, yes, no, no. But by doing that and having it programmed and ready to go, you've got your board, and then everyone gets the answers at the same time. It's not just you knowing the yes, yes, no, no, and having to say to everybody, okay, I'm getting yes, yes, no, no. This way everyone sees it all happening at the same time. So get your pendulum, and you want to hold it. You can hold it. You can hold it like this. You can hold it like this. As long as you can hold it and have your elbow steady, that's ideal. That's what you want. You don't want to basically force the pendulum to move based on your movements. I mean, if you're moving around, then the pendulum is going to move, because even as you're holding your hand steady, it's still feeling the vibrations, so it'll move based on you moving. You want your elbow to be planted firmly somewhere while you're doing this. So in my case, I have a little table here, but it's a little too low for you to see my board. But if I raise up my pendulum a little bit, you can actually see it. So that's what I'm gonna do. When you're preparing to program your pendulum, some people feel that they're more comfortable with giving theirs a little spin. And that's up to you. You can give yours a spin when you're preparing to program your pendulum, or you can go ahead and swing it so that it's starting out for you. For me personally, I don't. I generally leave mine very still. And then I'll get started programming it. And I say to it, I ask it for a yes, no, and maybe. I get it to show me what those are, and then I test it. So here we go. I'm going to say, pendulum, can you please give me a yes? Can you please identify yes for me? Pendulum, can you give me a yes? And I don't know if you can see, it's just very, very lightly, very lightly swaying. It's not doing much. So I asked for a yes, and I'm getting a very light sway. So I'm going to say, can you show me a strong yes? Please, can you show me a strong yes? Please, I need to know that you are getting a yes. Can you please give me a strong yes? And I am getting more movement. It is definitely moving a lot more than it was before, but it's still very faint. And it could just be, typically I do a lot better, in another room of my house. I feel like the communication comes a little bit more freely down there, so it might just be where I am. But then again, I'm going to continue to keep trying for you. I did a yes. Thank you very much. Now, can you please show me no? See, it seems to have stopped. Well, it still looks like it's swaying on your side because it's shaking. It's actually shaking a little bit. That could be coming off of my body. Can you please show me no? And we are moving. We're moving in the direction of no on my spirit board. Thank you. Can you show me a strong no? Can you give me a strong no? And it's still moving in the same direction. It doesn't seem to have picked up. It doesn't seem to be giving me a stronger response. So, like I said, I usually do a lot better in another area of my house. So maybe I should have done my video in the other area of the house. That's probably what you're saying. Yeah, I think so. But they're having an Overwatch tournament down there, so I don't think you would have really liked to have heard all of that, plus me. So anyways, I'm getting sidetracked here. So let's see. Thank you very much. Can you show me a maybe? Can you show me a maybe? And it seems to be moving again. It is giving me more of a diagonal response at this point. So even though I do have some answers, they're very light. I'm not getting very strong responses. I would suggest to you, because this works for me, is maybe moving to another area of your house or your haunted location and trying to get a stronger response there. So anyways, continuing on with my lesson, now that I feel like I've programmed mine, you want to test it. So the best way to do that is to ask it something that you already know the answer to. So in this case, I would say pendulum. Am I 37 years old? And wait and see what kind of response it gives you. If it gives you a yes to a question that you know is a yes answer, then you can feel pretty comfortable that it is programmed correctly. If it gives you a no to something that should have been a yes, then you want to restart your programming. It might be your energy. It might be your location. It might be your room. Take a break. Get some water, refresh, take a walk, come back, try again. You definitely don't want to rush it. It's not that sort of thing. Communicating with spirits has never been a rushed type of thing. You can't get them to respond on command, so you just got to give it some time. So in this case, I did get a yes for my my age question, but just to be sure that I got the right answer, now I'm going to ask it a question that I know is false. So am I 40? Can you please give me a yes or no? Am I 40 years old? And you want to wait and see if it gives you a corresponding answer. And it is actually starting to give me another response. It's swaying in the direction of no. It's a very light sway. Again, this is one of those situations, like I said, I would recommend going and trying in a different room. Even though I am getting an answer, it is a very faint answer. And I did ask it when I was programming it to show me a stronger response. And that was as strong as it was going to give me at the time. So and there it is. That's really all that you have to do to use your pendulum. Once you've got it programmed, you're in a place where you're comfortable, you seem to be getting very strong answers, then ask away. Ask your yes or no questions. You can't get anything. I mean, I guess you could. There are other spirit boards out there that that give you a wider range of letters to use, you know, or you can do some spirit divinations with your tarot cards as well, using the pendulum. Some people will use sand. There's a lot of different things for you to do. It's, like I said, it can be very fun, experimenting and, using for your spiritual communication. So I hope that you have your pendulum and you're ready to go. If not, you can definitely get one on our site. We have the spirit boards as well. They make great kits, and they're not that, they're not that big or thick, so when you have to fly somewhere and you need to take it with you, it can fit easily into your purse, your backpack, or your luggage, your carry-on, what have you. So they're fun little devices for using on your paranormal investigations. They're easy to bring with you, they're easy to conceal, and, you know, why not? If the idea is to communicate more freely with the spirits that are around you, this is one of those ways that you can do it without adding additional interference in the air with some other, you know, ghost hunter-ish type of communication tools. So anyways, that's using your pendulum. Hope that you get to using yours soon. Have fun. Bye.